Hello student, in our previous videos we have started our fifth module, that is the wind energy, and in that we have discussed some types of the wind turbine or wind machines, and also we have discussed about the different type of the rotors. Now in our previous video we have covered the different types of the rotors. We know that generally there are main two types of the wind machines. First is the vertical axis machine and second one is the horizontal axis machine, and these two types are based on the orientation of the axis of rotation. So these are the two main types of the wind machines, and further these two types, that is the horizontal axis machines and vertical axis machines, are further classified into different types. Now, and also we have discussed in our previous videos there are different types of the rotors, such as multi-blade type rotor, propeller type rotor, Savonius type rotor and Darius type rotor. These are the rotor is a very important part of the wind machine or wind turbine. Generally rotor consists of two parts. First is the blades and second one is the hub. Hub is the portion or the part which is present in between the blades, that is the blade is attached to the hub. So the rotor consists of main two parts, that is the blades and hub. Now in this video we will discuss about horizontal axis type wind machine, and after that we will discuss about the vertical axis type wind machines. So first start with that, the horizontal axis type machine. So let's see. In a horizontal axis machine, the rotor axis is horizontal and is continuously adjusted in a horizontal plane so that it is a parallel to the direction of the wind stream. As we discuss about the brief discussion about the horizontal axis type wind machine, that is a, what do you mean by the horizontal axis type machine. In a horizontal axis type machine, the axis of rotation is a horizontal and which is continuously adjusted so that it will be horizontal or parallel in a particular plane, so that it is a parallel to the direction of the wind stream. So this is the horizontal axis type wind turbine. Some of horizontal axis type windmills are briefly described below. As we mentioned before, the horizontal axis type wind turbine are further classified into different types. So generally there are five types, and these types depends on the type of the blade which is used in the wind machine or wind turbine. First type is the horizontal axis using two aerodynamic blades. That means in this type the axis of orientation is a horizontal or is adjusted so that it will be in a horizontal plane and it will be parallel to the wind stream or the direction of the wind, and it consists of two aerodynamic blades. So the name indicate that horizontal axis using two aerodynamic blades. So it consists of two blades. Second type is the horizontal axis propeller type using single blade. In this type only one blade is used, and this blade is used to convert the kinetic energy of the wind into the mechanical power, and after that there is a generation of electricity with the help of generator and other assembly which is used in a wind head. So this is the second type of the horizontal axis type wind machine. Third type is the horizontal axis multi-blade type. In this type the rotor is a multi-blade type, that means it consists of 12 or more than that blade. So according to the requirement of the production of the power or electricity, so according to that the system is constructed or the rotor is constructed So this is the third type, that is a horizontal axis multi-blade type. Fourth type is the horizontal axis Dutch type. In this system or in this wind machine, the main part is the gearbox. We know that generally the wind machine consists of gearbox, tower, rotor and nacelle part, and this nacelle part consists of different parts again, that is a yaw control. That is the yaw control is the system which control the speed of windmill according to the wind, and also it consists of the gearbox, some arrangement for the rotation of the rotor, and also it consists of generator. All these parts are present at the ground level in the Dutch type horizontal axis type wind turbine, because its blade occupy all the portion or all the part, so there is no place to place the gearbox or other assembly at the top of the windmill. So due to that, the all these parts are placed at the ground level. Fifth type is the horizontal axis sail type. In this wind machine, the blades are in the shape of sail type. So the name is given to that is a horizontal axis sail type, and the tip of the sail type blade is the concave, so that it releases maximum pressure or air pressure. So this is the horizontal axis sail type. Now we will discuss one by one. So first is the horizontal axis using two aerodynamic blades. This type of system consists of following important parts, such as generally any wind machine consists of same parts, little bit change or change in the only blade construction, or sometimes generator, gearbox and other assembly placed at the bottom or the at the top of the windmill. Depending on that, there are different types. So the basic parts are the same, and basic principle is also same for all type of the windmill. In a horizontal axis using two aerodynamic blades, the system consists of blades, rotors, shaft, gearbox, and last one is the supporting system. First is the blade. Blade is used to convert the kinetic energy of the wind into the mechanical power. So blade play very important role in the windmill or wind machine. Second is the rotor. Again, rotor consists of blades and hub, or sometimes there is a ten vane. So this help us to orient the windmill in the direction of the or along the according to the direction of the wind. So this is the rotor. Third one is the shaft and gearbox. Shaft and gearbox pass the mechanical power which is generated by the blades to the generator, and after that there is a generation of the electricity. And last one is the supporting system. All those blades and all these other parts are held at the top of the windmill with the help of supporting system, and generally which is the tower. And this tower, all these towers are made up from aluminium sheet or metal, or sometimes it is made up of cement and bricks. So this is the supporting system. This is the system schematic of a horizontal axis type windmill. Generally the windmill structure is the same but little bit difference. First we have to consider the horizontal axis aerodynamics two blade system. As shown in the figure, there are two blades, and these blades are attached to the central part, and which is the hub. We know that the rotor consists of two parts, that is a hub and blade, and these two parts are shown in the figure. And after that there is another part, nacelle. All these assemblies known as the nacelle, and which consist of drive system, yaw system, control and generator. All these components are combinedly placed in a particular box, and this is known as the nacelle, and the bottom part is the foundation. And all these rotor and nacelle is held on a held at a particular height with the help of supporting system, and which is the tower, and through that there is one cable. This cable passes the electricity from generator to the storage system, and after that the generation of the electricity from the wind, there is a storage system. This electricity is stored in that system, and whenever we want we can utilize, or we are able to give this electricity to grid. So this is the schematic of a horizontal axis type windmill. The rotor blades are continuously in a motion due to wind. We know that when there is a wind, then there is a motion of the blade, and these blades converts the kinetic energy of wind into the mechanical power. In this type, rotor drives a generator through a step up gear box. Not in this type, but in all types, generally rotor drives the generator. That means rotor consists of hub and blades. When there is a wind, there is a rotation of the blade, and these blades convert the kinetic energy of the wind into the mechanical power, and this mechanical power is given to the generator with the help of step of gearbox, and after that there is a generation of the electricity through the generator, and after that the mechanical energy easily get converted into electrical energy. But how? With the help of generator. The supporting structure of windmill that tower is made up of using aluminium foil. As we mentioned, the supporting system is generally made up of aluminium foil or in metal or cement or bricks. But in this type, the tower is made up of using aluminium foil. It may be tabular type, or it may have different shapes. From this system, we can get maximum energy in between 1 kilowatt to 5 kilowatt per day. Whenever speed of air is ranging between 40 km per hour to 60 km per hour. When we have this speed, which is lies in between 40 km per hour, that means within 1 hour, the wind covered the 40 km distance. That is, the wind speed is 40 km per hour to 60 km per hour. When we have the speed of wind lies in between this range, then we are able to collect the power which is lies in between 1 kilowatt to 5 kilowatt, and which is per day. So with the help of this system, we are able to collect the power which is lies in the range, that is 1 kilowatt to 5 kilowatt per day. It having efficiency near about 15 to 30%. That is, the efficiency of the horizontal axis aerodynamic blades, two aerodynamic blades, having efficiency near about 15 to 30%. So this is all about the horizontal axis two aerodynamic blades wind machine or wind turbine. It has some advantages as well as it has some disadvantages. So first we see the advantages. First advantage is it is easy to construct, because it only consists of two blades, and it is easy to construct. It can be easily convert mechanical energy into electrical energy. That means when there is a wind, the blades can easily rotate, and these blades convert kinetic energy or the kinetic energy into mechanical energy. Now after that, with the help of step up gearbox, there is a or step up through step up gearbox, the mechanical energy is given to the generator, and generator convert this mechanical energy into the electricity. So this is very easy process in this type. So this is the advantage of this system. Now it has some disadvantages. So first is the installation and maintenance cost is high. Installation cost is high because the cost of the rotor or cost of the blades is very high. So the installation cost is high, and it requires maintenance. That means there is a damage of the blades. Sometimes there is a damage of blades or some systems or tower, or there is a disturbance in the system. So the maintenance cost is also high for this type. Second disadvantage is its efficiency is not good. That means the efficiency of the system is not good, as well as it is not able to generate the electricity which we require. So this is the disadvantage of the system. Third disadvantage is the because of high cost of the blades, rotors with more than two blades are not recommended. That is, this type of system consists of two blades, that is aerodynamic blades, and the cost of these two blades are very high. So the cost of two blades is very high, so more than the two blades are not recommended because the cost is high. So these all are the advantages and disadvantages of the horizontal axis two aerodynamic blades wind machine or wind turbine. Now this is all about the first type of the horizontal axis wind machine. Now the second type is the horizontal axis propeller type using single blade. Now in this system only there is a single blade. A single blade windmill consists of following parts: single blade, hub, gearbox, generator, and fourth one is the tower. These all are the basic parts of the horizontal axis propeller type using single blade. In this type, a long blade is mounted on a rigid hub, which is shown in the following figure. The tower is a tabular type. Now, generally, we have mentioned the working principle and the construction of the all type of the windmill is the same, but there is a little bit difference. So there are different types depending on that. In horizontal axis propeller type using single blade, only one blade, and which is a large blade. So and after that there is a hub, and this single blade is fitted to that hub, and after that there is a gearbox and generator, and supporting system is the tower. And in this type, this tower is a tabular type. Induction generator and gearbox are also shown in the figure. Induction generator function is the same like a generator, that is it converts the mechanical power into the electricity, and through gearbox passes that mechanical power to the generator. The power extracted from wind by blade is transmitted through hub to a generator. That is, hub means rotor part, or after that there is a gearbox. When there is a wind, so due to wind there is a rotation of the blades, and these blades converts kinetic energy of the wind into the mechanical energy, and this mechanical energy is given to the generator through the hub and gearbox. So this is the horizontal axis single blade windmill. That is, in this type there is only one blade, that is a composite blade, large blade, and there is a rigid hub, that is a large part, and this hub consists of gearbox and induction generator, and there is sometimes pitch actuator. Pitch actuator is used to attach the blade to the hub, and there is a outer weight arm, because there is a for balancing purpose there is a outer weight arm, and the bottom assembly is the tower or the supporting system, and there is a wind direction is shown in the figure at a particular instant. So this is the horizontal axis single blade windmill. The power extracted from wind by blade is transmitted through hub to a generator, and this mechanical power gets converted into electricity. So this is the basic principle for all wind turbine. When there is a wind, then there is a rotation of the blade, and this blade convert kinetic energy of the wind into the mechanical energy, and this mechanical energy is given to the generator through hub and gearbox arrangement, and after that there is a generation of the electricity with the help of generator. Now it also has some advantages as well as disadvantages. First we see advantages. First advantage is it has low cost as compared to other, because there is only one blade. That means we know that generally the cost of the blades are very high, but in this system there is only one blade, so the cost of the system is also low. Second advantage is the due to single blade, weight of the system get reduced and hence easy to construct. We know that all these assembly, that is a rotor and other parts of the windmill, are placed at the top of the windmill at a certain height, and due to single blade there is a light weight of the overall system, and so it reduces the weight of the system and easy to construct. That means we can easily attach that single blade to the hub with the help of different arrangements. So these all are the advantages of the horizontal axis propeller type single blade wind machine or wind turbine, but it has some disadvantage. So first disadvantage is the due to large size of the blade, bending moments may occur due to sudden shift in the wind direction. We know that in this type there is only one blade, and which is a large blade. So when we have the wind speed is high, and if there is a sudden change in the wind direction, then there is a possibility to bend that blade due to high wind speed. So this is the disadvantage of this type of the system. So this is all about the propeller type single blade horizontal axis wind turbine. So these, in this video we have discussed these two types of the horizontal axis wind turbine. First is the horizontal axis with the two aerodynamic blades wind machine, and second one is the horizontal axis single blade wind turbine. So these all are the two types which we have been covered in this video. Now remaining types of the horizontal axis wind turbine we will discuss in our next video. So in that video we will continue with that.